Yep, that's big.
Hi, I'm Nate, and today we're talking about big babies. It's a topic I find myself discussing more and more frequently over the recent years, and I thought it'd be good to talk about the ins and outs of it. But first, how do we define a big baby? In medical lingo, we call big babies large for gestational age, and occasionally you may hear the term macrosomia thrown around. In reality, the definition of LGA is murky and can be different from hospital to hospital or even doctor to doctor. Indeed, when the baby is estimated to be 3,900 grams or 8 pounds 9, that may sound big for some women but reasonable for others. In most instances, we would say the baby's LGA if they're above the 90th percentile, which means that out of 100 babies at that point of the pregnancy, that child is bigger than at least 90 of them. Others may use the 95th percentile as their cutoff. Some maternity units may use customized antenatal growth charts, which will include your height, your weight, and your ethnicity to estimate how big baby should grow in relation to you. And then there are others who use specific weight to define LGA, the commonest being 4,000 grams, whilst others may have a greater cutoff at 4,500 grams. As you can see, how we define big babies is less clear-cut than you think. It's also important to know that even though ultrasound scan is the best way to estimate baby's weight, there's a 10 to 15% chance we may over or underestimate baby's size. For instance, if baby's estimated weight is 4,000 grams, baby's actual weight can be anywhere between 3,400 grams to 4,600 grams. Interestingly, if baby's estimated weight is greater, the risk of error also goes up, which means there's a greater chance we may be overestimating baby's weight. So why are we having this discussion if your baby's predicted to be big? Several years ago, there was a court case involving a mother with diabetes whose baby was predicted to be big. She did not receive appropriate counselling and not all management options were explored. Unfortunately, that had terrible consequences. Since then, healthcare professionals have become acutely aware to avoid such situations from recurring. Ultimately, we're here to provide you with information based on current scientific evidence and our professional experience so that you can make an informed decision about the care you receive. Is having a big baby normal? For the most part, yes. When we look at the percentiles, there will be some babies who are destined to be bigger than others. However, there may be conditions that may cause baby to grow at a greater rate, the commonest of which is diabetes. And so if you have a big baby on board and you're not known to be diabetic, you may be offered tests to diagnose for diabetes in pregnancy. And oftentimes, there is a discrepancy between baby's head size and tummy size on the scan. We also know that mums who carried big babies in the past are likely to have big babies again. And women who have a BMI of greater than 35 are likely to have big babies, and so are those expecting boys. Sorry, mum. So what are the concerns with having a big baby? The main one your healthcare professional will discuss with you is that of shoulder dystocia, which is what happened in the court case. Shoulder dystocia is when baby's head is born, but the shoulder is stuck, and it's often wedged against mum's pubic bone. It's an obstetric emergency as we want baby to be born as quickly as possible to avoid oxygen shortage. Reassuringly, when shoulder dystocia is suspected, most babies will be born quickly and without complication. And I'll have more information about shoulder dystocia in the next video. It's important to know that shoulder dystocia does not only occur to big babies. In fact, about 50% of cases occur to normally sized babies. However, being big usually means being in the top 10% of the weight class, which means a greater proportion of big babies are affected. The chance of shoulder dystocia happening tends to be highest for women who have diabetes before the pregnancy, who are also expecting a very big baby. Other things we worry about during childbirth is significant blood loss, which we call postpartum hemorrhage. Therefore, we recommend having active management to deliver the placenta to limit blood loss and the need for blood transfusion. When birthing a big baby, there's also a greater risk of a severe perineal tear, which involves the muscles of the back passage. This is also known as a third or fourth degree tear or an obstetric anal sphincter injury. Now that we know what the potential issues are, what should we do about it? Firstly, we can agree to do nothing and manage the rest of the pregnancy and labor expectantly. This can be a good option for you, especially if you wish to limit the amount of intervention that can happen during childbirth, especially since we cannot predict which birth is going to be complicated by shoulder dystocia. We can also offer an induction from 39 weeks of the pregnancy onwards, though some mothers may prefer an earlier date. The rationale for offering an induction is as pregnancy progresses, the baby will carry on growing, and so the risk of shoulder dystocia and other complications may be greater. The scientific evidence seems to agree that induction for LGA can reduce the risk of these complications arising. Lastly, we can choose to avoid a vaginal birth and schedule an elective cesarean section from 39 weeks of the pregnancy. Indeed, this will limit the risk of a complicated shoulder dystocia as well as avoiding severe perineal or vaginal tears. However, it will come with its own set of risks and implications for future pregnancies. I've previously covered cesarean births, so go check that video out. There is a specific group of women whom we would recommend elective cesarean birth, and these are women who have diabetes, especially before pregnancy, who are also carrying a baby weighing above 4,500 grams, as they are the likeliest to suffer from these complications. All babies are special, no matter their size, and all pregnancies and childbirth experiences are unique. I hope this video helps to inform your choices. Comment down below if you're expecting a big baby, as I'd love to hear from you. Share and subscribe to the channel for more information about pregnancies, and I'll see you again soon.